when Jesus was first tempted by the devil, before the start of his earthly ministry, one of the first answers that he gave to the devil in response to his temptations was that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. So, along those lines, when you first picture the word of God, what do you imagine? If you're like most Christians, then you picture the Bible as a book. But I'm not sure that's correct. And in this video, I'm going to quickly show you why. So when the Revelation mentions a person who is dressed in a robe dipped in blood, whose name is the Word of God, is it actually talking about the Bible as a book, or is it talking about Jesus? So when the Bible says in John 1:1 that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, is it talking about a book called the Bible, or is it actually talking about Jesus himself, the person? So if you're one of those people who believes that the Bible was around from the beginning, and that the Bible was what helped create the world, and that the Bible was God, let me ask you this. Which version of the Bible was it? You know, was it the King James Version? Was it the NIV? Was it the Catholic version of the Bible, which includes books like Sirach and Maccabees, which we don't include in modern Protestant versions? You see, while I do believe that the Bible is inspired or God-breathed, and that it's useful for training and for correction and for instruction in righteousness, I don't see anywhere in the Bible where it claims to be infallible. That's a description that is reserved for Christ alone, for Jesus, the only begotten Son of God. You know, there's a lot more that I could probably say about this topic, but maybe that's enough for now, just to give you something to think about. I just want you to bear in mind and remember that Jesus is the cornerstone of our faith. He's the author and finisher of our faith. And it's upon his words, that we need to build the foundation of our spiritual house. If we want to be able to survive the trials and the tests and the tribulations that are sure to come upon us in our spiritual journey. All right, guys, so that's it for this video for now. If this video has been an inspirational source for you, or if it's helped you to learn more about how to grow in your spiritual walk, then please do give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And please do hit the little bell button, which should be somewhere at the bottom, so that you can be notified as soon as new videos are released. I'd really love to hear from you now. You should see the email address somewhere on the screen. And remember, keep seeking the kingdom. God bless.